Hello, this is Becky Buttons with buttonmakers.net, and this is Watch Me Work From Home Edition. Today I'm going to show you how to use our 1¼-inch button templates to lay out a sheet of buttons with each one having a different color background. So this is my customer's artwork, and this is the 1¼-inch button template that in the native form when you download it from our website. Now, there are elements in this template that are made for Photoshop noobs who don't necessarily know how to use text along a path and some more advanced features, paths in general, which is not even just a Photoshop noob thing. Some people spend their whole lives working Photoshop, never use paths. So it's, but it is an important feature, and I use them a lot when I'm making buttons. So they're embedded in this template. You've got all this text, bunch of stuff going on. None of this is useful for me today. So I'm gonna delete all of it. I'm gonna click on the top layer. If you don't see your layers palette, you go to Windows and click on Layers. And then scroll down to this background layer. Don't even need that. And so I'm gonna just delete all of that to minimize that distraction for me. So all I have left is my face line and my cut line. The face line is important because it shows you where the graphic will stop on the face of the button, and the cut line is important because that shows you where to cut. When making buttons, you never really extend your art past your cut line because it makes it easier to see if it stops at the cut line or before the cut line. This is your bleed area in here. So this is where you stop your graphic and this is all bleed out. That's important to have to turn on and off. All right, so next we want to just drag in our artwork. And so with the move tool selected, I'm going to go ahead and click on my art and drag it in. Thank you. And it is not uncommon for your artwork to be ginormous compared to your button template. So you will have to oftentimes size the stuff down. You can do it before you drag it in. If you're smart, you could go to image and select image size. And then you can see that this is set to 300 pixels per inch. That's great. That's the same as this template is. And then your inches. So then you can resample this down since it's going to be 1¼ inches. It definitely can't be taller than 1¼ inches. And see, as you can see, it's still 3 inches wide. So it's still too big for our template. So now, because this artwork is such a weird aspect ratio, I think it'll lay out in the button a little bit better if I change the artwork up a bit. Of course, I would send a proof to my customer before running a production with a modified art. But because this doesn't really fit in the layout super well, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Also, this is giving me kind of like punk vibes, so I think I can do like a really easy cut and paste style on it. So I'm going to select this part of it and hit layer via cut. Then with the move tool, with auto select layer selected, I can move these individual pieces and cut this one out of layer one and hit right click on a Windows computer or click with two fingers or command and click on a Mac and layer via cut. And then I'm going to select my move tool again, and now I can move each of these individual pieces around. I'm going to hit Command T on my keyboard with bloody selected and then mouse over the corner until my transform tool turns into a rotate tool. Command T pulls up the transform tool so that you can easily rotate and resize your layers. So now with pickup selected, I'm going to hit Command T, drag that in. I don't think we want pickups to be smaller than bloody. This whole thing is still too big, but I like the layout. So then I'm going to select these three layers and hit Command T with them all selected, and drag this whole thing down. All right. Okay, and then I've got it moved kind of where I like it. So this is pretty good. I'm happy with this layout now. I'm going to turn off the face layer and then make a new layer above my art. And I'm also going to turn off my background layer. And then go to paths and select the cut line path. And then I'm going to turn that cut line into a selection. This is one of the reasons why having paths built into your file is super nice. So this is a selection. That's the right size. That's the cut line size on this button template. And then I'm going to hit select inverse. So now I have the inverse of the cut line selected. And then I'm going to hit this little guy over here, which changes that to black and white, and then hit this to swap the foreground for background color. Select my paint bucket tool, and then click inside my selection. So now what I have is basically like a solid pixel mask and a transparent background. The next thing I'm going to do is lay out my page. So you have to deselect it first. And basically this takes a snapshot of your pixels. This is such a cool feature. So you go to edit and then click define pattern. All right. And now you go over to your page document, and this is just an 8x10 size page at 300 PPI. You don't actually need the instruction layers or the background. You don't need these layers in here. They're just to help you understand the functioning like of this. I'm just gonna cover this with white and delete this one because it's not useful for us today. I need to have my overlay on its own layer so that I can color underneath it. So I had to create a new layer and then hit edit, fill with pattern and select that pattern, which remembers its transparency. If you turn off the background layer, you can see it's transparent back there. So now I've laid out a page of button designs with a transparent background, and I can color behind it. I can put a picture behind it. A gradient is a really fast and easy solution. Let me just show you that first. So I've got this on web color. So I'll select a colorful foreground and background color. So like red and blue. And then the gradient tool is usually hiding out behind the paint bucket. So then on the layer behind your graphic layer, you can fill in and make a very cool, very fast gradient. You could do then really quick, like you could make, yellow to green on a new layer, you know, and then you could cue one layer to the printer and then turn it off and cue the next layer to the printer. You could go like this, cue each one of those, then you could go boom. That looks kind of gross, but you know, change the layer opacity and blend the two together. Or not, that looks like toilet water. Okay, and then for this, what I had intended to do was do like a solid color, like more of a rainbow. So each one a different color, different solid color. So to do that, I'm just going to select my paintbrush tool. And I really like my keyboard commands. The left and right bracket makes this a different size. So you can make it smaller, 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 or larger, larger, larger. And then you can also use your shift right bracket to make the brush harder or softer. It's really handy when you're coloring in, you know, if you want a foofy background, you know, I don't know, you might do something like that. But for this purpose, we want a solid, hard color in the background. So I'm gonna make a brush size that's, excuse me, just bigger than my button graphic, each one. And then I'm just gonna start selecting different colors back here. All right, and making just different. I like to put it on web colors for this, so it's a little easier to just like select the nice big bright color, you know. And this is just a little bit easier and a little bit faster than like trying to, you know, make a bunch of layers and do it in your button template and flatten each one and drag it to a page and flatten and drag it to a page. You can work on the whole page, you know, at one time. Maybe if I had like a bloody drippy paint looking paintbrush, I could do blood drips down them, and each one would have like a different drip. Maybe on their next order, the bloody pickups will do that. We'll do a Halloween special. All right, so yeah, you get the idea. Like, you can just put like whatever you want back here. You could start getting crazy with it with the gray tones. Why not? But yeah, the buttonmakers.net templates are super cool. I use them myself in everyday production, and I'm happy to get feedback on them. They've improved over the years due to customer feedback too. So if you have any you know, questions, concerns, or want any help with doing button orders or anything like that, please let me know, and I'm ready to make some colorful buttons. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time on Watch Me Work.